Welcome to the Polyvagal Breathing Practice Series. In this series, we combine an aspect or understanding of the vagus nerve with the breath practice. In this video, we're looking at the sensory motor aspects of the vagus nerve. The vagus is both broadcasting or sending information to the body for how best to adapt to a given situation. And it's also receiving information from the body. In fact, it receives much more information from the body than instructions that it sends. So this is just so empowering because as we understand this aspect, we can send signals to our own brain that creates a sense of calm, of safety and connection in our system, in my system. Okay. And then as I create safety and connection in my own system, that influences others around me through mirror neurons, which we'll get to in another video. So, sensory motor. This right here is sensory motor, all of our fine motor skills. And so I want to invite us to use these incredible biofeedback tools to get started with our breath practice. I invite you just to go ahead and place a hand on your heart. If you want to, you can place another one down on your belly and breathe. And just feel the body breathing. Just that sensation of feeling the body breathing. And if that creates a sense of ease in your system, just stick with that one. And if you want to move forward, you can go ahead and put your hands underneath your armpits with your thumbs up for a butterfly hug. And breathe. The warmth under my armpits, the sensation of the body breathing, the containment, like just that close in hug. This all feels really nice. Feel and breathe. So you also have wonderful biofeedback tools in the bottom of your feet with the intricate bone structure in your feet and all the layers of muscles and nerves and tendons. So plug in, connect, and just find all of those little spots, all the little details, and you're connecting with you. No matter where you are, you can plug in, connect. You're sending all this information to your brain. Engage all the subtle circuitry in the body. Just notice what happens with your posture and your core as you connect in with you. Now, there are many other aspects of our senses, so our sight, our smell, taste, our hearing. So all these are also involved in perceiving if things are safe or dangerous. So we can use that as a tool. So we can use our eyes and our face as part of this. So just go ahead, soft cheeks, soft eyes, soft gaze. Ah. The awe just opens up some of that auditory processing too. And from this place, a soft gaze, just to distinguish details in your environment. So go ahead and point. Is that crossbody function, gesture, to whatever you see around you. Just notice all the details. Just notice this beautiful rose. See all the details in this painting I adore. And just notice things around you, this beautiful quilt, all the details. And then we're also in motor, like we're notice how you're turning your head. So that's, you're connected with you. And we're connected into the wider vision field. Okay, and so when we're in that motion, it helps cue the system for ease. And when we're in our broad vision field. So you can use these tools, the fine motor skills, to touch, to plug in, to connect, to send that sense of ease to your brain. So let's just take another minute sitting here together and breathing. And we'll just do 6 breath cycles here. Connect in, plug in. Be in touch. Put your hands on your legs. Be in touch there. Feel all the sensation of the fabric. Feel the muscles that are there. Yeah, just notice. Put that hand back on the heart if you like that. Be in touch with you. Connect. So the natural state of the nervous system is ease and connecting in with yourself. I hope you find a little more of that in this neurobiology lab of you. Enjoy your practice.